Stanford University.
The Amazon basin is about the size of the continental United States. That's a big area.
It's impossible.
It's rainforest, but there are also natural savannas. There are mountains with cloud forest on top, and there are flooded forests. My research is about how indigenous peoples interact with plants and animals, both economically and spiritually, and how that interaction affects how many and what types of plants and animals you find around indigenous villages. We trained all the indigenous peoples, about 300 of them, to do the work, and they actually collected the data. Because of that, we were able to collect huge amounts of data over 20,000 square miles. We're finding that many of these species, for example, the white-lipped peccary and probably the tapir, tend to be most common nearer to the communities than in remote areas where no people live and where there's no hunting. We're also finding that the traditional religion, shamanism, is also very important as a means of managing these plants and animals. There are certain rules that come out of the religion that determine what animals can be hunted, by whom, and where. When you take a map and you map out all the places that they killed an animal, you will see that they never go in those areas. So it's quantitative proof that these spiritual areas are actually functioning as sort of reservoirs for animals. From a scientific perspective, we would say that that is management. That's creating protected areas where animals are not hunted. Indigenous peoples are not having the negative impact on biodiversity and animal abundance that has so far been written in the majority of publications and literature that's out there. Their impact is not that negative.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.